everyone. Today, I'm actually heading back to Tokyo from Fujisawa, so I'm checking out of my hotel soon. We're gonna make a stop in Yokohama. I really wanna check out the garden there because they have one of the most beautiful gardens, so I'm really looking forward to checking it out. It's been on my list for a while. It is rainy today. The past couple of days have been rainy in Fujisawa, but it has still been really beautiful. If you guys want to check out my trip in Fujisawa, Kamakura, that was my last video, so make sure to check that out. And I'll be releasing the rest of my Japan travel series from this spring 2023 trip. So make sure you're subscribed to my channel so you know when the next video is available, because I'm going to be in Tokyo for a week, so I'm going to be working there, which is, I think, what's going to be covered in this video. So mainly Tokyo. Then my friends Kimmy and Sean come in at the end of the week, and I'll be hanging out with them. So we're going to go to Hiroshima, Osaka, Kyoto, then back to Tokyo. So that'll be a jam-packed. I have no idea what's gonna happen. So I'm still figuring out like exactly how I'm gonna be releasing these videos. So again, just make sure you're subscribed to my channel because we're gonna figure it out together. I am excited. Let's get this day started. I need to check out soon and I am not done packing. So yes.
We ended up not going to the garden in Yokohama. One, because I couldn't find a locker for my luggage, and two, it was pouring rain. It ended up being fortuitous that I didn't find a locker, because the day that we did go to Yokohama ended up being one of the most beautiful, with lots of freshly bloomed cherry blossoms, which you'll see more of later.
Sunday, so I cut off the sheets. In the rain.
In the middle of the street.
Yeah, NBD.
My next hotel room was located in the heart of Ginza. I love staying in Ginza because it's a central location within Tokyo, making the train rides shorter and easier to get to major destinations. Since our Yokohama plan failed and it was pouring rain, my friend and I ended up spending most of the day inside. This was pretty easy to do considering Ginza is one of the main shopping areas in Tokyo. High-rise shopping centers and multi-level stores line the streets. I was on a mission during the shopping day. A mission to find an umbrella. The thing about rain in Japan is that it can also come with an intense amount of wind, meaning you need a good, sturdy umbrella that won't flip on you. Once the umbrella was secured, we went to a coffee shop to rest and catch up. After two rounds of coffee and a heartfelt, "I can't believe this is my life" conversation with Amy, we walked over to my favorite place to get miso fish in Tokyo. If you've seen my other Tokyo videos, you know how much I love this place.
Hey everyone, good morning from Ginza. Yesterday was just a lot of coffee, catching up with my friend Amy, and today I was just gonna spend the day working, but then I decided I kind of want to go over to one of the temples and check out the cherry blossoms because it's spring in Japan, why not? I really feel like this trip I'm just trying to kind of just play by ear, go with my gut, and my gut is telling me to just take the time to go see some cherry blossoms. So today we're going to Asakusa and we're gonna go to Sensō-ji temple. So we're gonna head over there. I think it takes about 25-30 minutes to get there from Ginza. It's not supposed to rain, but we'll see. I did look up cafes before leaving the hotel. We'll see how it all works out, but yeah, we're just going with the flow today, and the main goal is to actually find a place to eventually sit down and get a bunch of work done because I'm way behind on stuff. Let's go.
If you're looking to beat the crowds at Sensō-ji Temple, visit in the morning. The vendors may not all be open on Nakamise-dori Street, but trust me, you'll get a much better photo and experience at the temple in the morning. I visited Sensō-ji Temple in my last Tokyo video, which was filmed during the winter, but I wanted to see if I could spot some cherry blossoms this time. Sensō-ji Temple is one of Tokyo's oldest temples, originally built in 628 AD. But the current buildings are post-war constructions. There are lots of little areas around the temple to explore, eat, pray, and see bloomed sakura. Leading up to the temple is Nakamise-dori, a shopping street with many traditional snacks, crafts, and souvenirs. The street was already getting crowded, but I was determined to eat some of my favorite Japanese snacks before heading out. Also, if you're curious about all the rabbits everywhere, it's because this video was filmed in spring 2023 during the Year of the Rabbit. I'm really glad that I made time to do a little bit of sightseeing, but I really needed to get some work done. I tried to go to a couple of different cafes on my list, but all of the ones in the area were packed. I ended up heading to a cafe in Shibuya that I knew typically had spots available to work. Thankfully, I found a seat with a couple of outlets to charge my phone and laptop. All I did for the rest of the day was work for a few hours and then head back to the hotel for a really early night in with some konbini, onigiri, snacks, and Netflix. I allowed myself to rest because I knew my schedule was about to be go, go, go once my friends got to town. The next day did not go as planned. I think the jet lag was starting to hit a bit because I woke up late and missed my train out to Chiba. I had a whole Chiba train adventure planned for the day, but oh well. I guess that will be for another trip. Already flustered from missing my train, I sought a place to relax and escape the herd of people at Tokyo Station. I discovered a restaurant on one of the top floors of a mall attached to the station that served matcha and Japanese sweets. Unlike my last trip to Japan in the fall, I didn't do much planning for this trip, which is highly unusual for me. Usually I have spreadsheets filled with all the places I want to see. But I really head into this trip with a go-with-the-flow attitude. I wanted to let go and just see where the wind took me. And apparently, the wind was not taking me to Chiba on this trip. Instead, it took me back to Shibuya, where I strolled through Miyashita Park, and then to a spicy mabu tofu noodle restaurant I liked in Omotesando. This spring 2023 chapter in my series is different, and I'm excited to show you all the places it took me. The next day, I finally got to visit the garden in Yokohama, and the weather was perfect. Yokohama is about an hour away from Tokyo via railway, making it an easy day trip. There is so much to see and do. I've been wanting to visit the Sankeien Garden for a while now, because it's supposed to be one of the most beautiful gardens in Japan, and man, it did not disappoint. Before entering the main garden, we stumbled upon the Shanghai Yokohama Friendship Garden. The wildlife, lily pads, and winding bridges were a sight to see. Once we arrived at the main Sankeien Garden, we immediately understood why it's considered a national scenic spot. spectacularly fluffy, freshly bloomed sakura trees surrounded a beautiful, picturesque lake. I was honestly shocked at the size of the garden. Not shown are the different levels of the garden and the 17 historic buildings relocated here from places all around Japan. There is so much to see at Sankeien. However, today, all we wanted to do was take in the sakura while we could.
Happy garden. Amy.
Yay!
All right. This is so good. What is this again?
Amazake.
Amazake, sweet sake.
Sakura season is typically sometime between March and April. But seeing cherry blossoms in Japan is all about timing, because they only stay bloomed for a couple of days. The fleeting beauty of sakura has become a symbol for change, new beginnings, and appreciation for the impermanence of life. I used to not understand why sakura season was such a big deal. They're just flowers. But being in Japan during peak season and seeing the fluffy flowers go from bud to bloom to falling petals that look like snow, I now get it. The fragility of the flowers makes you appreciate and cherish them even more when you get the chance to see them. Travel costs during the springtime in Japan are at an all-time high. It is peak season for travel here. However, I honestly think it's worth it. After the garden, we were ready for some food and coffee. We found a coffee shop closer to the pier with a stunning view of the water. We stayed there for a bit before moving on to find a cafe that had outlets so that we could do some work. We might have gotten a little distracted looking around at all the shops and dogs, but can you blame us? I love walking around Yokohama. There's a nice vibe and liveliness to the area. Plus, we stumbled upon even more gigantic sakura trees. I took a mental note to take my friends here later in the week. So in upcoming videos, you will discover even more things to do in Yokohama. Honestly, I am so excited to share the rest of my spring trip in Japan, where I'll take you with me to Osaka, Kyoto, Hiroshima, Nara, Wakayama, Nagoya, and show you even more of Tokyo. There will also be a mix between traveling with friends, working in Japan, discovering more about my family, going on solo adventures, and more. So make sure you're subscribed to my channel with notifications turned on, so you know when the next episode is available. Until next time.